much, huh? Thank you very much. Good evening, everybody. My name's Linda. Behind me is Matt on the, what do you call that?
Bouzouki.
It's not really a bouzouki, though, right? Because bouzouki is traditionally a Greek instrument. So
well, traditionally, but, you know, the Irish stole it in the 60s and then made
and
it
here
their
we
own.
Are. It's sort of an octave mandolin. Anyway, it's a wonderful instrument. So he's back there behind me. We kind of set this up as a, trying to be like a session in a pub. So we've got the table. We don't have any beer. So if anyone has
or
any,
whiskey,
bring it on
or...
up. But anyway, we've got the got table in the middle. We've got some, you know, our phones, of course. And then over here on the banjo and the mandolin and the fiddle is Tor. And then on the far side is Candy on the fiddle right now, but she's going to be playing the accordion as well. So what we're doing tonight is just a whole range of lots of different tunes, lots of our favorites, and hopefully they are entertaining. We are aiming to just have fun. So that's what we're doing. First of all, we want to dedicate this performance to our friend Michelle, who we recently lost, as in today. So raise a glass to Michelle. Yeah. I have tissue up on, it's one of the things on the table. Yeah, so anyway, here's to Michelle. But also, on the, you see a table, a little table up here in the front. I've actually got some note cards there with pens and pencils. If anybody has a question about Irish music, or St. Patrick's Day, or Ireland, or whatever it is, the fiddle, anything at all, write your question on one of those cards, and there's a little plastic box on the stage. If I see you put it in the box, I'll go up and grab it, and we will answer your question. So, anyway, we're going to have Tor start out some reels here.
Single reels, yes.
Single reels. Here we go.
Yeah, single.
Thank you.
How about a hand for Jason and Shelby? Those guys are amazing. This was all sort of thrown together at the last minute, and it worked out great that, you know, Jason over there and Shelby over there, it's perfect.
They did wonderful.
Yeah. So we are now going to have Matt sing a song, right? That's what's next? Yes.
Sure.
So the song is called Raglan Road. This has quite a history. The song is actually a poem written in like 1847 and then was put to music. The music was from an old Irish language song from like, I don't even know when. Not sure of the year. But anyway, so it has a progression. It was a poem, then it was put to a melody that existed. Then it
Dawning of the Day. Dawning of the Day.
That is the English translation of
right.
it. And then it was made popular back in the early 70s by a fabulous group called the Dubliners, Luke Kelly, the singer, and has been recorded by everyone from Sinead O'Connor to Billy Joel, even.
Really?
From what I read, yeah. But anyway, so here is Matt and Raglan Road.
A little song about some heartbreak, a little bit. Yearning, all that good stuff. On Raglan Road, on an autumn day, I saw her. Thank you.
That was beautiful. That's such a wonderful song.
So sad.
One of my favorites.
And just since it was so pretty, we're going to now play some really fast polkas. So these, I don't know how many people have ever gone to a dance and they play a polka and you're thinking like flouncy dresses or Lawrence Welk or, you know, Bubbles, whatever. Anyway, this is not that kind of a polka.
Well,
these are Irish polkas.
The fog. I mean.
We did have the fog machine. That was cool. But anyway, these are three different Irish-style polkas, and the third one, just picture James Bond. I see somebody has put something in my little basket, so give me a second to go grab the question.
Oh, what are we supposed to do? Talk about the next tune.
Talk about how... Earlier we were discussing the fact that all these tunes sound the same. Is that right?
Yeah, we were. Oh, actually, you know what? It's not coming up yet.
No.
But we do. Oh, well, now we're too late.
Oh, no.
I can wait.
Okay. Well, okay. Should we give him a preview?
Oh, my goodness. Okay. This is actually quite a good question. I have no idea. What is the national color of Ireland?
Blue.
Candy says blue. Why is it blue? Explain.
It's blue.
Explain.
Oh my goodness. Like about 4 years ago
in the microphone.
Yeah. It wasn't green.
You would think it's green, but evidently it's not green.
Blue.
There you go. The answer is blue.
Wow.
Thought you could trip us up with that one, huh?
Yeah.
It's
a library. The library knows.
Hold on, I'll go look it up. There's a library there.
The whole building dedicated to that question. Right over there.
Or there's Google.
There's Google.
All right, so we've done jigs, we've done reels, we did a song, we did some polkas. I think we're going to do jigs again. Now, you notice that we have set lists and we have our iPads and we're all sort of switching around and looking at stuff. There are so many tunes. After a certain age, you can't remember them all. I know hundreds of tunes, but if somebody tells me a name, I'll say, yeah, I think I know it. How does it go? So anyway, the iPad is to help me remember how it goes. So here's some jigs.
Funny, they usually ask me the name, and I go, oh.
All right. This is all you. Yes, yes.
Is it?
One, yeah. Two, three, four.
Thank you.
you notice Tor over there juggling instruments. He's gotten quite good at it.
Yeah, it's the microphone that gets in the way.
Just juggle it along with the instruments. So we are now going to play. We've done some fast stuff and some faster stuff, and we're going to now slow down just a little bit. This is actually going to be a waltz. It's okay. This is a weird thing. If you know anything about music and time signatures, this is actually two different tunes, a waltz and a mazurka, which is based on a Polish folk dance. But they're both in three-quarter time, and they sound completely different. So this is going to be the Merino Waltz, which picture a cafe in Paris, even though it was written by a very well-known Irish musician, also part of the Dubliners, right?
Yeah, John Sheehan.
John Sheehan, yeah. Anyway, he wrote this waltz, so it's not French at all, but it certainly sounds like it. So we're going to start this with the Merino Waltz.
Thank you.
like that.
So that last one is called Sonny's Mazurka, in case you want to look it up and learn it.
Yeah.
Okay, we've got some more questions. Give me a second.
Okay, so while she's doing that, I can't see out there very well. How many of you can tell the tunes apart? Raise your hands if you can tell the tunes apart. Come on. I think you're lying. I think you can't really. How about you?
Sure, I can tell them apart.
No, I doubt it very seriously.
I know the different keys.
Okay, that's different than knowing the actual tunes.
I don't know the tunes.
Okay, right, fine, yeah, fine.
I just play bouzouki.
So what we're gonna do is a little bit later on, we're gonna play another set of tunes, and you're gonna know this tune before we play it. How's that?
I have no idea what he's talking about.
How's that for a teaser, huh?
That sounded vaguely threatening.
That's pretty
good.
You're
gonna know it.
You're gonna know it.
You're gonna like it.
We're gonna teach
okay.
this tune.
Okay, we've got a question. Here we go. I remember Sweet Molly Malone from grade school. Can you play that? Do you know that?
Sweet Molly Malone?
Molly Malone.
Oh, Molly Malone.
Yeah.
Was she sweet?
Do you know the song?
Yeah.
Want to just give it a shot?
Sure.
No pressure.
We have no idea how this is going to turn out, but hey, it's on the paper. Let's see
something
what happens.
About Sweet Molly.
You and your papers.
You and your papers.
Yeah, I can barely do a passable
now
Irish
get
accent.
Requests.
Oh no! Here we go. Okay.
Yeah, see what does the other paper say? Don't play Molly Malone's because that'd be great.
The other one says, "When was the first St. Patrick's Day celebrated? Probably right when he got rid of all those snakes, I would think."
It was in 11, and
I bet you it was well after he was dead. But that's. Again, there's a big building right
I don't
to your
know the
left.
The answer to that question.
Oh, St. Patrick's Day is according to the dancer.
Shelby.
St. Patrick's Day is an Irish-American tradition. Not.
Yeah, but
not
so
an
the
Irish
so
tradition.
Then the question remains, when was the first one celebrated? Was it a big parade in Boston or
I bet you
Plymouth.
I bet you it was a bunch of guys on a Sunday morning getting drunk, and then
probably
they were like, "You know what? We should make this a holiday."
It was the Macy's guys saying, "We need a parade."
What's today? Okay. Tuesday.
It's just a guess.
So this is the kind of thing that happens at a session. We just sit around and talk and laugh and play music.
Okay,
so here we go.
Molly
it's
Malone.
A lot worse when it's at session.
Here we go.
Oh right, that's me.
All
right.
On you.
Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty. I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. Wheeled a wheelbarrow through the streets, broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Remember, if you're not singing, you have to listen to me singing. She was a fishmonger, and sure, it was no wonder that so were her father and mother before. They wheeled and wheelbarrows through the streets, broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She died of a fever, no one could save her, and that was the end of sweet Molly Malone. Now a ghost wheels a barrel. Broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh. Crying cockles and mussels. Alive, alive, oh. Alive, alive, oh.
was the beautiful. Vocal styling. Thank you so much for that, for that request. So we are going to continue. We've got some reels.
Real,
yeah.
Oh, yeah, so these are definitely reels.
I actually recorded a CD a few years ago. Not that it means anything at all, but anyway, the only reason I mention it, because this set of tunes is on that recording. And the names of the tunes are so long, if you list all of them, they end up, it takes way too much space. So I just named this tune on the CD Tripping, because the very first tune is called Tripping Down the Stairs. So this is our Tripping set.
Not to be confused with Tripping Up the Stairs.
Hold on to your hands.
Different tune. So here's Tripping Down the Stairs.
Okay. Yep. We're ready when you are.
We've got more questions.
So on this tune business. So I want you to repeat after me. Da 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 da. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Now, if you want to be, so you just played the bare part of a tune. Most Irish tunes, you'll notice, has a lot of little flecks in it, little ornaments. You'll notice that I do a lot of little picky bits. So does she. She flicks her little fingers. So you can go da 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 da. So pretend you're drunk. So let's try to. So ready? 1, 2, 3. Da 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 da. Okay. They know the tune.
There we go.
All right.
So questions. They know it before we play it.
That's exactly.
Ah, there we go. The mystery has been solved. Okay, questions. Here we go. First one. Can you please, pretty please, play Castle Kelly? Do you guys know that tune?
Do you know it?
Not. It's not on my list. I'd have to dig it up on my iPad. Anyway, great tune though. I used to play it. Yep. Okay, next one. What is the oldest song you have played before? Probably the one we just did, the Raglan Road. 1800s, right?
Oh.
Maybe? When did Ireland become its own country? Long time ago. Don't know that.
When did Shebeg Shemore get written?
Don't know that either.
I think that was 17.
1924 was what? When Ireland was declared, I don't know what.
Yeah.
I'm not very good on the history.
All right,
of
someone
Ireland,
go into the history part of the library and go grab a book.
You're literally asking musicians history questions.
Now, if you ask me about a jig or a reel, I can probably answer that. Okay, one last question. I'm going to just read it. Is it hard to play the fiddle, and what age did you learn the fiddle, and do you guys like playing your instruments? Can you jig? Meaning, can we dance? No, that's why we're sitting up here.
That's right.
We let the dancers dance.
That's why we have our lovely dancers to come out and jig for us.
Yeah, yeah.
So anyway, in answer to that question, it is hard to play because there are no frets, so there's nothing to tell you where to put your fingers. You have to be able to hear the notes. And I started when I was 10. So there you go.
You have another question.
Oh, my gosh. You guys are writing books here.
Hey, Shelby.
I might need glasses. 12 centuries after the death of St. Patrick. Okay, she went to the library. She actually went to the library and took notes. Okay, so 12 centuries after the death of St. Patrick, Ireland began feast day in celebration of him. St. Patrick's Day began in America around 1737 after a large influx of Irish immigrants who very much missed home. So there you go. We've all learned something today. Now we can go home, right?
Thank you, Shelby. That was awesome.
The take-home message here is don't ask a musician, ask a dancer.
Because we don't know anything.
And in response, we are going to play some jigs. This starts out with one called The Spotted Dog. And if Luke is here, this is for you.
Yeah, this is the dot one. Okay, so wait. May I? No, just want to make sure.
You may not.
We're playing until 8:45, right? Is that correct?
So right.
Yeah.
So just wait.
Okay.
So just sing your part real quick. Okay. All right.
We're gonna sing along with you. This is the audience participation.
Yeah.
Participation.
And I'm gonna help you out. Okay. Just remember, you're singing on just the first tune. Just wanted to let you know, in case you decided to keep on going. They do change, and that's the whole point of this. So sweet, Lord.
It was my choice to give him a microphone. I'm sorry.
You did this to us, Linda.
All right, here we go. 1, 2, 1, 2. Da 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 Excellent, excellent participation.
Good job,
y'all. 15 minutes? 15 minutes. Ooh, we get to go. Okay, it's 8:35. There's a big clock up there. It's 8:35. So we get to go till 8:50. So let's go ahead and do a song. And so we're skipping one on the list.
Okay.
We don't have to skip. We have a bunch. And we've sort of filled some time with questions. And I know there's a bunch more questions. So let me grab those really fast.
No. Let Chris go get them. We can play while Chris grabs them. Too late.
Wow.
Holy moly. Okay. I'm going to read really fast. Why are black cats unlucky? Okay. I don't.
They're not.
Where's the library again?
I have one at home named Murphy, and he's very lucky.
When and how did you all meet? Probably at a pub.
That's true.
What is Ireland's national anthem, and can you play it? I actually don't know that.
I don't know it.
Unofficial.
Not sure. How old is the group? What time is it?
About an hour and 36 minutes.
And how is it? Okay, I'm not sure what that means. How did you meet? Once again, we're all part of a group of local musicians in the DFW area. We all play the same music. We get together for sessions just like this, but usually at a pub. So we all show up on a Wednesday night or a Sunday afternoon, and we just hang out and play music. And where? One of the on Wednesday, the place is called The Celt, and it's in McKinney, right on the square. Great, great pub.
Sundays as well, 3 to 6.
Yep.
Can you please play She Moved Through the Fair? Oh, my goodness. That's a beautiful song. Probably not today,
definitely,
but
can't sing that
great
one.
Song. Where is Ireland located? In the ocean.
That way.
It's a big island.
It's not untrue.
On one side is the Atlantic. On the other side is the Irish Sea. Hey,
and
who
right,
knew?
West of Great Britain.
It's next.
Yeah, kind of, if you look at the map, yeah. The UK, Great Britain is right there. Well, anyway, it's Ireland is to the west.
It's to the left of England.
No, your other left.
Your other left.
What is Ireland's national animal?
I don't know.
Sheep? Scotland's is the unicorn, so...
Irish what?
Hair. H-A-R-E, hair. Okay.
I thought
he
said bear.
Can you play your favorite song? That's actually, that might be coming up. I love the song we're going to be playing next. Yeah. Heartbroken to hear about Michelle. Thank you, yes. If anybody knows the musicians that we hang out with, Michelle was one of our oldest friends, a great fiddler, and very much missed. Okay, I can't. Okay, I'm back to the black cats. I don't know why they're unlucky.
They're not.
I want to stand corrected. I said 1924 was when Ireland Ireland separated from Great Britain. It was 1922. And 10 years ago, Her Majesty Queen was the first monarch to visit Ireland since the separation, and they gave her this huge raving ovation, standing ovation. And that told me that Ireland and Great Britain are finally at peace. And if Ireland and Great Britain can be at peace, so can the rest of the world.
I certainly hope so. Here's a song.
Here's a song about a little woodland creature.
Might be a national animal somewhere. Who knows?
Maybe Ireland.
Tennessee.
Well, fox went out on a chilly night, breaking the moon again in light, boy, many miles ago that night, boy, we reached the town, no, town, no, town, no, many miles ago that night, boy, we reached the town, no. Well, they ran to the gate to the farmer's den, guns and the geese kept their in, said a couple of years gonna grease my chin before we leave this town, no, town, no, town, no, a couple of years gonna grease my chin before we leave. Down, no. gray goose by the neck, threw the duck across his back, and he did mine. The quack, 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 with the legs all dingling down, no, down, no, down, no, he did mine. The quack, 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 and the legs all dingling down, no. Well, the old gray woman jumped down the bed. Out of the window she popped her head, crying, John, John, the gray goose is gone, and the fox is on the down, no, down, no, down, no. There were the little ones, 8, 9, 10, saying, Daddy, Daddy, better go back again. Must be a mighty fine town, no, town, no, town, no. Daddy, Daddy, better go back again. Must be a mighty fine town, no. Well, the fox and his wife without any stripe cut up that goose with a fork and knife, and they never had such a supper in their life. And the little ones chewed on the bones, oh, bones, oh, bones, oh. They never had such a supper in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones.
Thank you very much.
That was great.
That's a fun song.
I do like that one.
Yep.
All right, 8:42. We have 8 minutes. So should we skip to?
Don't skip any.
Don't skip any. Okay, we're going to do some jigs next then. We're going to do the Escher set.
Yes.
Yes? Yes.
Written the first one.
So this starts out with a jig that I wrote. And you've probably seen Chris up here on the stage walking around, giving me hand signals and stuff. He actually named this tune. This is called Escher's Staircase. And I don't know if you've ever seen the painting or etching that Escher did of the staircase that kind of walks around into each other. The steps, like, connect. It's very strange, like 3D weird. Anyway, the tune kind of wraps around itself, so... Escher's Staircase, and then after that is one called The Maho Snaps, and then The Cat's Meow. And if you want to know where the names come from, the story I just told you about Escher's Staircase, that's kind of where they come from. There's a picture or a person or a place or whatever. So here we go, Escher's.
Thank you.
So I don't know if you noticed, but every now and then you'll hear me or whoever say, hup. That's actually our way to indicate that we're coming to the end of the tune. And at a session, you can play a tune as many times as you want, 10, 12 times, it doesn't matter. But when you come to the end and you're ready to go to the next one, whatever that might be, the hup is a way to let everyone know we're changing tunes. So, hup. We're going to do another waltz. And this one actually was written by a French guy. I can't tell you his name. I have no recollection. I did look it up once. But anyway, this is called Crested Hens. The original French title was the Pullet something or other Pullet. I don't know. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Isn't the Crested Hen a reel?
Started off as a reel. Yeah, it started off as a reel.
Yeah.
See, the tunes evolve just like everything else.
French
There's probably something
player.
In the library about it. Anyway, this is going to be a waltz into a couple of reels. And yeah, it's going to go fast after it goes slow for a minute.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, everybody. We hope you have enjoyed the evening. We want to say thank you to Tom for having us, to the Allen Library for having us, and also to Shelby and Jason, our dancers. Once again, I'm Linda. This is Matthew behind me, Tor over there, and that's Candy. And we wish you all a very happy and safe St. Patrick's Day weekend. Thank you.
And thank you for our sound guys, our technicians, for helping us get set up and everything. Y'all were amazing. Thank you, guys.